I should change the old text, shouldn't I? Today you'll be moving some coal to Dewsnap. You've been informed that another O4 ahead of you is struggling due to the weather. Keep an eye out for red signals. Oh dear. That's going to be a problem for me then. It doesn't need water. Remember, we need to check that, yeah? Right, while we get moving, I'll update the Twitch name. Yeah, no pressure, Jesse. Dark is only sitting there with his Google Doc waiting. It sounds like a choir girl singing. Cheers, Speedy. Thanks for joining us. Hope everything goes well. Yeah, that's correct. The next stream will be on Sunday night or Monday night. It depends really whether or not I get what time I get back from my parents. It'll either be if all is well time wise, it'll be Sunday. Failing that, it'll be Monday. You know what, Doc? That's never happened. No, I'm serious, it's never happened. I have been driving an electric train and suddenly run out of electric power, though. But that was the fact that I'd set the route up wrong. Power wasn't supposed to have disappeared. Oh, and then there was the times when I first started playing with London Faversham in the early days of development. And I hadn't really figured out the whole switching powers and I thought I'd done it right. So I left Ebbsfleet Station, heading for heading down HS1, went down into the tunnel, and then started doing this under the Thames. Because of course I hadn't got any power, so I went down into the tunnel, and then couldn't get back out again. That's absolutely fine, Dave. That is exactly why I do the YouTube uploads. Cheers, ACML. See you later. Thanks for joining us again. No, the diesel does seem to take quite a long time to go down. I never played them for long enough. And it's quite unusual for people to start scenarios that they make with the fuel level being low down as well, which is a shame actually, because it could provide an extra challenge for people to have to make it somewhere with less fuel on their locos. Lovely. Industrial grungy feeling of this route, made all the more colourful and pretty by the snow. Just sucks the colour out of everything. Amber signal, so I just need to get ready to stop at the next one. Well, it's actually, you say that, Dave, one of the very first scenarios actually written for the game. Back in the days of Rail Simulator, was a scenario on the Somerset and Dorset route in the Rusty Black 5, and that one involved you starting with limited fuel as well. That was quite good actually, that one, considering the vintage. Stop injecting water before we start priming. Yes, we're changing junctions. Don't really need the blower on this one, Sapphire. And to be honest, the blower is really only any good if you want to when you're not really going very fast or going into a tunnel. once you're actually going a reasonable speed, the draft actually of the air over the chimney is actually more effective than the blower anyway. So you're no better off with the blower. Yeah, it's a good shout, Pete. Had a bit of loco care into the whole thing. Safeties are going off anyway. Welcome back, Lee. Ah, this is the train that's in front of us, blocking our way. So we should get a clear signal to this block in a minute when that train is passed. Oops, started stoking up, and we forgot to stop stoking up. That's not good. Hey, we can get going. Open the regulator all the way, shove the fire out the chimney. Thank you. there's not much point continuing on at the moment because we're at a red signal. So we won't rush. Thank you, safety, for going off. Hope we've got a grain. But the distance for the next signal is still on, so we're only one block in advance. It says we're currently 6.3 miles away from our next waypoint. We're about 8 miles away from our final destination. Hey, thanks for the follow there, Test J. Much appreciated. I'm still on the minus medals, Matt. Yeah, well, I'm always on minus medals, you know me. Need a little bit of extra braking there. Come on, stop. Stop. Stop, I tells ya. Thank you, God. Didn't see that, yeah? As long as we're all clear on that you didn't see that. Come on, Juju. Or am I just going to get up to there? Hey, DeBrocca. Thanks for joining. Is that train prep going to get its bum moving? Time to go Superman and have a look at this other train. I guess it stopped to let some cars go through? At least it's going again. Hey, you got the green. Thank you.
There goes our safety again. Water time. Welcome back, Hugo. There's my signal. Well, we've just got the green. Stopping again. Oh, I do like that brake squeal. That was very nice. Yeah, I tell you what, Doc, definitely a stopping service tonight. Hugo, no, I'm going to park for this scenario. I usually try and finish up by about midnight or so, and with this scenario it's probably going to be about 20 past midnight when we finish, so I will call it a night at that point. We've got three more off of the list though, probably about 10 more added to it, but that's fine. Have a look around workshop, folks. See what you can find in the way of great scenarios, or make one yourself even, and upload it, and I'll play it on the Twitch. If you find one that you recommend, then let me know, I'll take a look. Particularly like the one we just played today on Horseshoe Curve, that was stunning. Oh, we got the rain. Hey there, Jerry M, welcome to the channel. Hey distance signal is on, so we need to be careful. Hey, thanks for the follow, Jerry M. Much appreciated. Stop! Thank you. Hey, Ellie. Welcome. Cheers, Sapphire. Much appreciated. Have a good weekend yourself. Thank you. Yeah, the YouTube is making its way up to nearly up to 200 now as well. And an interesting stat for those that like stats: the YouTube page is actually videos on our YouTube page are being watched around about 1,000 hours. 24 hours a day, pretty much. As in 24 hours worth of videos. Which is pretty cool. Hey Chrissy, welcome back. Gonna stop injecting that before we start priming. We'll be going past that signal in a minute. Welcome back, hot dog. Wow, that's gone up. Must have had a few while we've been doing the stream. I'm sure it was only about 170 or 180. The signal is red because we are following a rather faulty train in front of us. We were warned about that at the beginning of the scenario, that we might get snarled up behind a slow-running train. Thank you. Welcome, Nick and Jim Binks. Welcome back. Seems to be a bit of a gap between the that signal and the other one. No sign of the next signal coming up at the moment, which is good. Oh, the other train's managed to pick up a little bit of speed. He's actually going to get to the next signal before we get to ours. So I might be able to run straight through there. Hey, welcome back, Dave. Distance is off, so we're clear to run through the next signal. Although, given the distance between those two, I guess that one probably will stay red. The distance on that one is off as well, which is really good. It's funny, I was having exactly this conversation with my son this morning on the way home from work, and we were talking about how he loves the sound of electric locos and I love the sound of steam engines. Hi Dave, no, I don't really stream any other games. I might do some flight sim or some Duffdale fishing at some point, but my predominant interest is in the train sim. And to be honest, if you think that I've got bad skills in this game, you should see me in other games. Horrible feeling there that was my signal. I didn't spot that one. Yeah, get your head out the cab window. That's how I'm driving it, and my view is gorgeous. Just about 2¾ miles now to our waypoint. I guess that other train either found the accelerator or have been rerouted somewhere else. Oh, the primey, naughty boy. Thank you. Cheers, hot dog. See you later. Kind of a 1 in 40 at the moment, which is why we're running a bit from the slower side. Hey, I'm pretty much going about as fast as I can at the moment. We're going up a really steep gradient, and well, this little engine seems to be doing about as much as it can. We are accelerating though, just about, and boiler pressure is just about holding out. Obviously without the load I could go faster, but the point of the scenario I guess is I've got to bring these wagons with me. He doesn't seem to be doing much work. Get off if you're not going to pay your way. Wow, this hill just doesn't quit. Hey Chrissy, yes, I'm running a scenario. This is, oh hang on, pressed the wrong button here. Let's try that. Beneath the Black Skies, which comes with the Robinson 04 pack. L, what button? I'm not sure what button you're referring to. The boiler pressure is now finally getting low enough that we're losing speed. If you mean the reverser, the blue disc, this one, it's the on a steam engine, it's the cutoff, and it controls the flow of steam into the cylinders. It also controls the direction, but it also controls how efficient we're using steam. So I'm just juggling it, trying to try and get enough of it to keep the train moving. Sadly, we've got just about to the top by the looks of it, and I'm going to have to stop and blow up the engine a bit. The black one, if you mean this one, is the train brake, so that operates the vacuum brakes.
Oh, we're running really low on boiler pressure now. Things are getting desperate. Well, it looks like we've nearly made it to the top. Come on! I've got my blower on, Hugo, so I'm actually okay. If you've got your blower on, you think you can get away with having the fire door open at least a bit. There's the top, look, it's right there. It's here. Keep going. Now all of a sudden the boiler pressure is going to go up. Where are we anyway? We've made it here. We're gonna go around here. Into here. Cross over. Cross over all of those. And then we're gonna end up in PW Goods 08. So this is for putting coal in. This is how much coal there is in the tender, or the bunker for a tank engine, and this is how much there is in the firebox. So what you want to try and do is learn what the ideal number for that is, because this is your boiler pressure, which is how much raw steam you've got access to. As in my case, I'm running incredibly low on boiler pressure. This is water, so the top number is the amount of water I've got available in the tank or the tender. The bottom is how much is actually in the boiler. You receive a message via radio from the station master at Penistone. Due to the large amount of snowfall, it's not possible to continue beyond Penistone, so we'll be stopping at PW Goods 08. This is where you put water into the boiler. You don't want to let the 62% go below about 15% at the worst, otherwise you can find it melts the fusible plugs and the boiler and the train will stop and be dead. Cheers, Doug. See you later. So you want to keep that probably somewhere between 50 and 75%. This one's probably going to be in the order of 60 to 80% somewhere is where your ideal mass is. And then your goal is to keep the boiler pressure as high as you can get it. So the way you operate that is you manage your boiler with the cutoff. So if I bring the cutoff back, then the boiler pressure will go up a bit faster, but I'll have less available to me. I think we're just starting. Oh, we're still speeding up. So if you constantly drive with the blue one all the way forwards, you'll find you're running out of steam on a regular basis. So you pull the cutoff back as you go. The train brake, you want to make sure you're always leaving that in a running state, because in the release state you're going to use boiler pressure as well. Regulator pretty much does what the regulator says it does. So to start, just to recap, when you're starting the train off, first cut off all the way forward,
frame rate all the way down to release. Once it's released, the brakes, put it back up to running, and then you can push off with the regulator. Keep an eye on the water level and the coal level, and also watch your boiler pressure, because if you run out of boiler pressure, you're stopping. Pretty much that's the reason we're not going very fast at the moment. This one here tells you what the pressure is on the brakes. So in most steam engines, 21 inches means the brakes are released, 0 inches means the brakes are fully applied. And the way it works is you move the brake lever up a bit and that starts going down. And then when it's gone down to the way you want it, so say you wanted it 15 inches, which is a moderate brake application, you then put this back into the running state and it will mostly hold it at the same level. So you can, that's one of the problems that some people have, is that they put it up to say 30%, thinking they're getting 30% braking application, and what happens is it comes screeching to a halt. And it's because at 30% this has continued to apply over and over continually, and eventually it got to zero, which means you're at a full brake application. This control down here is the blower, which helps put a bit more airflow through the fire, which can help to boost the boiler pressure if you are going slow or stopped. Once you start moving beyond a few miles per hour, you're actually getting enough draft over the front of the main chimney that it really exceeds what the blower can do anyway. Oh my god, a red light. Believe I do. So see, I put it back into running and it stayed, this stays at the same level, and we just gently start slowing down. And because we're stopping, I'm going to put the cutoff back to the top and press the C key to open the cylinder cocks, ready for when we start. Let's get some boiler water in the boiler. What's holding us up? Looks like nothing. Have we got permission? We do. Alright, let's go. So just press tab there to request permission to pass the signal, and indeed we've been given a call on indicator which tells us that we are able to proceed. And we've now got the green, so I probably just stopped too early. The Y means that we're heading into the yard. Whatever the steam generation problems were, they seem to have been fixed. That's fine, Hugo. If you go back and have a look through some of the other videos on YouTube, I've got some where I actually talk through learning to drive a steam engine a bit more, including the epic fail where I ran out of water. However, before I ran out of water, there was a lot of good stuff. So that one might be worth a look. A Jubilee Loco running over the Settler Carlisle. If that helps you find it. Well, you mentioned that, Dave, on the Mallard, I mean, one of the things, I did the scenario, the speed test scenario that comes with, and one of my hopes with that one was A, people would have fun, and B, having to push it to its limit actually encourages you to learn how to drive it better and how to manage the cutoff and the boiler pressure and so forth in quite an interesting way. So, and I've certainly had the feedback that that seems to be the case. People do seem to be learning to get more out of the steam engine so they can try and get faster speed and better times. Nearly there. It's just here now. Oh dear, Dave. I actually did a speed test run on the Mallard scenario. I didn't get anywhere near as fast as I've had in the past, but have a look. I've got a lot more than 150. I think we made about 110. So there might be some tips and tricks that you can learn, and perhaps improve upon, and send them back to me. We made it. The snow will need to be cleared before your wagons can be transported to Dewsnap. You've finished this scenario. Fantastic! Right, that's all from me tonight. Hope everyone's enjoyed it as much as I have. And the next show will be on Sunday night or Monday night, depending on what time I get back in. I'll try and let everyone know in advance, but failing that, come and check out on night at 9:30 Sunday night. If I'm not around, then I'll see you on Monday at 9:30. Thanks again, everybody. Have a good weekend. Bye-bye.